Can you do a paternity test before the baby is born?
Wouldn't it have been better to not take the risk of there being more than one father?
The father has doubts he is the father, and he doesn't want to risk having his name on the birth certificate, and liable for child support he can't get out of without tons of legal fees if it's proven the baby isn't his later.
When they do amniocentesis, they collect a genetic sample from the baby and can do genetic testing for various disorders before the baby is born.
I think that has a risk of miscarriage associated with it.
So does chorionic villus sampling, which is taking a small sample of tissue from the placenta, and regardless of whether they do CVS or amniocentesis, they can do paternity testing from those samples.
The downside of amniocentesis is that they can't really do it until the 16th week, plus or minus 2 weeks.
I guess you don't want to wait that long. CVS can be done earlier, as early as week 10 depending on the doctor's office.
I don't want to take the risks. I thought there were newer non-invasive methods for determining paternity.
When a woman gets pregnant, the placenta leaks just a little bit and some of the baby's DNA gets into the mother's bloodstream.
That's why women who had sons had a higher risk per some study of certain types of cancer, and why women who have had children have better tissue regeneration in some circumstances, as if some of the baby's stem cells helped the mother.
Non-invasive paternity testing or NIP culls the baby's DNA from the cells in the mother's blood, and that DNA is compared to the alleged father.
That sounds like the sort of testing we want to do, getting an answer before the baby is born without risking it being born too soon.
NIP can be done after the 8th week of pregnancy, and it is supposed to be accurate to 1 in a 1,000.
That's more accurate than ultrasound for gender determination.
If you do a genetic test for various conditions, the information on the baby's sex is 100%.
We need to know the baby's daddy to 100% or whatever level is accurate enough for the court.
When they do NIP testing for paternity, they will say the alleged father is either excluded as the father, meaning he can't be, or cannot be excluded, which means he might be.
An answer saying he might be the father might be cause for saying we'll do another test later, but a test saying he isn't the father is clear enough, though I don't know if we can do it soon enough.
Remember that you can't do prenatal DNA testing through a maternal blood sample until the 10th week. But this approach does mean you can do the blood samples at any lab and send it to one of the few that do this test, even if there isn't a local one.
How accurate are the NIP tests?
They say around 99%, though you should have all potential fathers do the test to at least get a clear nope, not him answer.
Then there's the question of whether or not the results are inaccurate because I was wrong on the conception date.
Then you do the blood test again another few weeks later, when the results will be more accurate and with less uncertainty and drama, fit for a reality show.